It's time to make Larry Bundy Jr.'s favorite video, an unboxing video. Yeah! Let's do this, bitches. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do an unboxing of is the LG Optimus V smartphone for Virgin Mobile. Now, if you guys watch my Black Friday video, you know the story behind this. I thought I lost my Kyocera Law phone. I didn't lose it. When I got back home, I found it and I went on an epic search for this phone. Luckily, I got it. This phone I actually had in the past before. I brought it back because I was going to save up for the $299 Motorola Triumph. I realized they didn't need it and I regretted bringing this back. So when I saw they had it for $49, I had to get my hands on it, and lo and behold, I did. So let's do an unboxing. You can see what it comes with. Okay, so here it is, the LG Optimus V smartphone. Notice this on the bottom right here. It actually has physical buttons, not touch-sensitive capacitive buttons. Such a beautiful feature. I used to have an Android, a Samsung Intercept, and the Samsung Intercept had the four capacitive buttons, and because that phone was so laggy and because the buttons were so sensitive, either they wouldn't respond or they were hypersensitive, and if you had the phone against your face, they would respond to everything and you would get jump out of a call, you would go to the home screen when you didn't want to. That is the best feature. That's why when I first purchased the HTC Wildfire S, it looked like a good phone. I probably would have enjoyed it, but I was very hesitant about the four capacitive buttons. It didn't have physical buttons, so that was another reason I was psyched about getting this one. But anyway, let's crack it open here. All right, there's the phone itself. It's a really good looking phone. It's not overly pretty. It's not the best looking phone on the market, but it still has a very clean, solid look. Box right here kind of shows you how to start the phone up. On the back here, it tells you all the preloaded apps it comes with. Navigation system on Android phones, in case any of you guys don't have Android phones, is awesome. When I had my Samsung Intercept, it saved me many a times to have that if you're lost in the middle of nowhere. YouTube runs really good on this. Obviously, it comes with Gmail, kind of typical things with Android. I'm not going to go into detail with this. So I'm probably going to review this phone, so I'm not going to go into all the details. All right, let's get it out of the box, if I can without killing myself. Yeah, I gotta love when they make these boxes because they want to make sure no one's gonna steal it. Okay. It's not a hardcore blister pack. Sweet. Okay. Let's crack this open and put the phone aside for a second. Hello. Upside down. Hello. Very big instruction manual, which you don't need. Android is pretty self-explanatory. And of course it comes with a micro USB cable for your charger. Here's your charger here. I have 1,000 micro USB chargers which will charge this phone. So I may just put this charger to the side and save it in case I ever need it, in case the other ones break. A pair of headphones here, which is unnecessary but nice. I actually think these have a mic on them too, so if you don't have a Bluetooth headset. And a micro SD to SD card adapter, so you can plug this into your computer and download files, songs, video, photos to it. Here is the battery itself. It's a 1500 milliamp battery. Battery life on this phone isn't fantastic. It's better if you live in a high service area, but if you have low service like I do where I live at home, that's the problem. It's constantly searching for signal, and that's what kills the battery. When the antenna is constantly looking for a connection, it searches for any kind of connection, and if it can't find one, that drains battery life big time. So just keep that in mind. And that's pretty much any Android phone from any carrier and any brand. Okay, that was a hardcore fail. My battery died from my camcorder. So while it was dead and charging, I actually activated this phone, and I'm already on Twitter. And it took like 5 to 10 minutes to activate. It was fantastic. And as you see, the phone is very responsive. The most interesting thing about this, I'm not going to go into details, I'm going to review this phone, have a review up later in the week, is this phone actually has a 600 megahertz processor. The Samsung Intercept I previously had an 800 megahertz processor. So you think, oh wow, the Samsung Intercept is a much faster phone. Not the case. This phone is way more responsive than the Samsung Intercept, and it runs apps much better. It starts up much quicker. Say the battery dies, you have to restart the phone. You'll be into the operating system in 30 seconds, 20 seconds, as opposed to sometimes a couple minutes for the Samsung Intercept. Much better phone all around. So I'll go into full detail later on in the week, like I said, but it was very easy to set up and I'm looking forward to using this phone again. Okay, so on to Black Friday item number two. You saw the big GameStop box. And I could tell that my friend Sean from up in Hudson, New York is gonna drive down here and rest his man sack on my forehead and give me some Christmas cheer, because I swore to him I wasn't gonna do this, but I couldn't resist. The deal was too good and it only cost me 18 bucks in the end. I'll explain. Let's dive into the bag. I'm gonna do this handheld. Thank God for image stabilization. So, that should already give it away already. That should definitely give it away. Remember, 18 bucks. I'm not that much of an idiot. And yeah, I got a 360 again, even after all the hell I went through again. After I swore I wouldn't get one again, I had to do it. I had two PS3s. One I had with my workstation, one I gave to my family. My family never used the newer PS3, which is the one I gave to them. I went to them, I asked them, hey, do you mind if I take it back? They're like, yeah, we never used it. They used it once when I first gave it to them. My older PS3 was out of warranty. I don't like keeping hardware when it's out of warranty because I'm anal. Because if something happens, I don't feel like sending it back to the company when it's out of warranty and spending money on it. I'd rather trade it in and get something new. So GameStop was having the whole $50 extra credit. They were giving me $150 for the PS3 alone, traded in two games, and that got me everything you see here. It got me the system. It got me 3 months of Xbox Live for 12 bucks or like $11.99 or whatever. And it got me this game. And honestly, when this game came out, I knew I was getting a 360 again. I'm not gonna lie. I may have talked a bunch of crap, but I went from being the biggest Halo hater to being one of the biggest Halo fanboys. I love it. I cannot wait to open this up and play it. So, sure, what the hell, I'll do an unboxing. You know why I'm gonna do an unboxing? Because I love Larry Bundy Jr. and I know he loves unboxing so much that he'll jump off a bridge when he sees this one. He can't stand them. He told me specifically he can't stand unboxings, but he's an awesome guy and I'm just messing with him right now. So anyway, Halo. No, I'm not unboxing that. Forget all that. 4GB 360. You've seen this 1,000 times. How can I do this one-handed without killing myself or killing the 360? Alright, you know what? I'm not unboxing it. You've seen 1,000 slim 360s before. Anyway, guys, this is Rich of Review Tech USA. Hope you enjoyed this semi-unboxing where I unboxed my phone but didn't unbox the 360. But you've seen it before, and I'm sure you don't need to see a disc. So hope you enjoyed it. I will have more videos up later on this week. And make sure you participate in the petitions to block SOPA and protect IP. You have no idea how important that is. All right, guys, have a good one. Have a good Sunday. I'll have new videos up soon.